Hello, I'm Guillaume Millet. I'm the CTO of AV Simulation, and today I will. Pardon. Okay, I will talk to you about the new physics-based rendering engine based on Unreal in Scalian. So first, why we have chosen Unreal engine. So first thing is why leaving OpenScene Graph. So OpenScene Graph has been used for more than 14 years of what can call good and loyal services. So some picture of what has been done using OpenScene Graph since the start. So OpenScene Graph is a good 3D rendering engine. It's based on OpenGL, which is not yet obsolete, but it's now not the primary API for new feature on graphic board. So OpenScene Graph 3.6 we are currently using should be the last version of this library. We know that the main developer moved to a new project. And there is no native support for new technologies like physics-based rendering, ray tracing, and things like that. So if you still use OpenScene Graph and you want to use advanced feature of new boards, you have to almost redo everything using the OpenGL API. So it's a lot of work, and it's difficult to follow the technologies. So this is why we have choose to move to Unreal. So why Unreal? Basically, it's one of the best on the market game engine. A lot of high quality games are based on this engine, and Epic Games has currently a strategy to help company like us to use this engine for other applications than game. It's natively compatible with almost all latest technology of 3D rendering. Performance, so as it's used by a lot of games, so Epic Games and graphic board manufacturer, they have to work together to optimize the engine and the driver and the board for us. So they work for us directly. We don't have to work with NVIDIA. The work is done by Epic Games for us. It has a lot of evolutions. It's written in C++, so it's important for us because we are mainly having C++ developer in AV simulation. It's still multi-platform, so we will be able to provide the visual on Windows and Linux as before. The source code is available. So the advantage for us and for you is a little bit of security of investment. So if tomorrow Epic Games changes strategy, we are not blocked. And also, it's royalty free. I will talk after. So royalty free, so you don't have to manage another license protection system on the computer, so it's more easier to deploy. And also Epic Games has a marketplace around Unreal, so there are a lot of content that are available free or for a reasonable cost on the marketplace to enrich your simulations. So what is photorealism? We use for that what it's called physics-based rendering, PBR. So it's mainly a light and material model that allow to simulate almost any materials with just few parameters. So it's really more advanced than the standard Phong model we can find in OpenGL, and it will allow us to provide physics-based rendering for simulation image. So the question is now how we use Unreal in Scanner. So the first thing is that it's not exactly like before. It's not a 3D library you use like OpenCinemaGraph. It's a full game engine. So we and you will have to change a little bit your mindset to use such tool. The way you prepare your data is different. The way of customizing is different. And we have worked a lot to integrate this technology with this way of doing things within Scanner without losing Scanner strengths. So the objective is that this new Unreal Visual should be usable by non-developer. It's not as before. You will be able to create your simulation almost as before in Scanner, and it should be efficient and still open. So the new architecture we use, so it's fully compatible with the Scanner Studio. The new visual application for Unreal is plugin based. So we don't, it's not a full customized version of Unreal Engine, but we, it's a standard Unreal Engine with new feature for connecting to Scanner. And you will be able to develop your own Unreal application with Vuro plugin to customize the rendering. I will go deeper in that after. And you will be also capable to reuse your existing assets you already use in OpenCinemaGraph. So the architecture is quite standard, like in Scanner Studio. So you have your Scanner bus, you have Scanner Studio here, you have your module of Scanner talking with each other on the Scanner bus. And now you will have the new component here, the Scanner U engine, which is just a rendering engine. It's not a Scanner module. And you have a Scanner module that does the gateway between both components. So the Scanner U Visual is a Scanner standard module, and the Scanner U Engine is a standard Unreal application built directly from Unreal. So this architecture allows you to customize the Unreal application part. So with Scanner 2021, we will provide what we call a template application. So we provide an Unreal project, which is a template to create your own Unreal application. So if you want to customize the rendering, you can use this project, generate your own Unreal application, and it will be usable with Scanner. Or if you just want to use Unreal Visual as before, you have nothing to do, just you launch the U Visual module and everything works as before. So to use such technology, we need to have new assets, no 3D assets to feed the rendering engine, because if you put the same information at input, you will have almost the same rendering as output. So we have worked a lot on the asset workflow. So we will provide a tool to convert existing OpenCinemaGraph assets to Unreal format. This will allow you to directly use your existing asset without having to invest into new assets. The quality will be a little bit improved because we do some treatment, so some processing to change some materials to take benefits of the new rendering engine. The default data of Scanner are already provided in the Unreal format to be directly usable. We will provide a tool to do the data preparation that will need for this version, for this first version, that will need to be, you will need to have Unreal to be installed on the computer to do the data preparation, because what we provide are scripts that do automate the task into the editor to provide the pack file, which is a binary compiled version of the assets. But we are still working on that to improve, and we are working to a new workflow using DataSmith. So DataSmith is a tool, we can call a tool, and a little bit a file format in Unreal that allow to import almost any 3D format. So it's mainly designed for CAD data, but we can be used for a lot of 3D format. So this DataSmith is already available in Unreal Engine, but you can't load DataSmith file directly on at runtime. So this new feature is under development, and it's in the new 4.26 version that is currently under preview. So Scanner Visual will be based on this version. So we are waiting for the official release of this version to be able to load directly at runtime object in the DataSmith format that will be that can be prepared directly using Scanner Studio Terrain. So Scanner Studio Terrain will involve to include native export to DataSmith that will be directly usable in Unreal, or you can use any DataSmith supported plugin or format. So I will show you some images of the current status. So this is the visual is working, is not yet feature complete, but it works. So some rendering of Lake City map with Unreal Engine. We have some rendering of the same scene with different kind of with weather and lighting conditions. Okay, put some time to have a look to everything. We also have the multiple viewport support, so you can, as before, if you have a single computer with multiple screen, you can create multi-viewport configurations. So here it's six viewports, so three mains and three mirrors. And now I will put you a short video about the current status of rendering. So it's not fake, it's really the application used with Scanner. So as I say, all that you what you see here will be available in this first release of Unreal Visual. So the video is a compilation of some weather lighting effect running directly with Scanner. So for some, you can recognize some existing 3D environment from already existing. So you can see that you can reuse your existing asset within Unreal, and you will have an improved rendering quality using, but you are still using the same assets. So this is so you have seen what is already working in Scanner. So as I say before, currently the rendering, the visual based on Unreal is still based on the preview version of the Unreal Engine, as we are using some latest feature of the Unreal Engine. So for up to now, the Scanner Unreal Visual Module will be a preview version, but it will be available for everybody having a visual module in Scanner. So it's everybody, because visual module is in standard package. It's main feature are already, as you have seen on the video, almost everything basic feature of Scanner is working with this new visual. It can be used for visual rendering or for camera sensor simulation. You also have some camera sensor rendering with distortion and things like that are already available. But there are some limitations on this first version. It will be almost single computer, so you can launch several visuals. It's not an issue because it's not separate computers. But there is no synchronization between rendering, so we can't guarantee that images produced on two different computers will match at the border. So this is why we call it single computer. But on a single computer, you can already use several viewports to manage several screens. It's running only on real-time mode. There is no non-real-time mode available yet. We have to work on that. And there is not yet a Linux version, so it's planned. But it's, up to now, it's Windows only. So, as I said, so moving to Unreal is not just a small development. It's a full strategy. So we will not stop with this first version. We still have a lot of topics to manage within our roadmap to use this technology. So. As I said before, so we will have to support multiple display systems, warping, blending, to be able to use this rendering engine within large simulators. We will also have to manage all about tracking to support cave system, also to add HMD support. So HMD is working in Unreal, but what we want to do is to make it ready to use and plug and play almost as in current visual. And a big topic with this new technology, we have a lot of opportunity to really improve the headlight simulation, because we will have access to ray tracing and a lot of very nice features to improve the headlight simulation rendering. So this is our future development roadmap about Unreal. And as you know, Unreal is also evolving very fast. So I'm sure we will have new topics coming soon. Okay, thank you. And if you have some questions, you can ask it on the chat.
Well, so thank you again for your presentation. We already have some questions. The first one is, do we need Unreal to be deployed on computers?
No and yes. It depends on your use case. If you want just to use the standard visual as today in Scanner, you don't have Unreal to be deployed. We will provide everything within the Scanner installer, and you just start the module and it will work. If you want to create content So create and or convert your own asset, you will need to have Unreal on this on the data prep computer. And obviously, if you want to customize the Unreal application using the template we will provide, you will need to have Unreal on the computer. But for standard running of standard visual application we provide, you don't need to have Unreal installed.
Thank you. Another question, is that possible to import terrain created from MathWorks Roadrunner into Scanner UE engine?
We don't have done the test, but there is no reason we can't do it, as we provide almost everything to convert. We will be based on DataSmith file format, which is provided by Unreal. So I hope that Roadrunner will also provide an export to DataSmith, and in that case, it should be very easy and straight line to import. But I think there are a lot of solutions. You can go through FBX, you can go through a lot of formats. So as I can imagine, there is no big issue about doing that.
Okay, thank you. Third question, how to create content for this new visual?
So you have several solutions. So first solution is, as today, you can use the Scanner Studio Terrain to create your road environment. You will have a DataSmith export option to Unreal. So this DataSmith will be usable directly at runtime, or you can import it in the Unreal editor and enhance it. You can still use 3ds Max or any modeling tools that can provide FBX, for example. And so you can almost use anything, any tools. You may need to go through the Unreal Editor to improve or to manage materials, but there is no big limitation for that. You can use almost any tool.
Another question, is it possible to use Scanner UE engine completely as an alternative of Scanner? What is the advantage to use both Scanner and UE at the same time?
UE, no, because the simulation models are in Scanner, so the current implementation of Unreal Engine Visual and Scanner is managing only the visual rendering. The simulation models are still in Scanner. We have our own vehicle dynamics model named Calais that is better than the physics we can do natively in Unreal Engine. We have our own traffic model. So the models are still in Scanner, and Unreal Engine is here in this first iteration only used for visual rendering.
Thank you. Another question, is it ready for production?
As I say, the answer is between. It's usable, it's working, it's not feature complete, but it's usable. You can use it on a workstation application or things like that. You can't use it on simulators because we don't synchronize images between several image generators. So the answer is it depends, but for basic application, I think you can use it already, and please use it and do some feedback, because it's a big change in Scanner, so we will really need your feedback to improve it.
Well, last question. Will performances be the same as OpenSim Graph with the NVIDIA Quattro, or we need to change to NVIDIA RTX cards?
I think it will be better to use RTX board, because we use ray tracing feature of Unreal Engine, so that are accelerated in RTX, but it's still compatible with existing board. So it's not mandatory to change. It will be compatible. We will provide three, I think this is three or four presets of rendering options to be able to adapt the rendering to the hardware you have. But there are a lot of very nice feature we can have with ray tracing. So I think having hardware accelerated ray tracing will be mandatory in the near future.
Okay, thank you very much. The session is over. If you have any questions left, you can contact us. And thank you all for your participation. I let you go to the next session, which starts in 5 minutes. Thank you.